Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, kids, as the case may be. So today we are going to discuss the answers of the English sample paper that is being provided to you for your UT first examinations. So let's begin the discussion with the very first question. So the first question is tick the correct option. You have to read the question, and from the following option you have to tick the correct option. First one, the girl was wearing dash color frock. So the girl was wearing purple color frock. Chakravarti lived on dash floor. Sixth floor on Patel Street. Lieutenant Colonel Sanjay Singh have dash moustache. We know that Lieutenant Colonel Sanjay Singh have thick moustaches. Milk is dash noun. Milk is material noun. Second form of verb of arise. The second form of verb arise is arose, and the third form is arisen. So the correct answer will be arose. Herd of the cattle is dash noun. It's collective. Themselves is dead pronoun. Themselves is reflexive pronoun. How many shops were there on the street? We are talking about the Patel Street. So there were total 67 shops there. Shop number 63 was of. The shop number 63 was of Leo Toys. A small house not built very well is called. The house that is small and it is not properly built is known as the shack. So the correct answer will be shack. Now let's come to the reading section that you have to read the passage carefully for answer the questions. The paragraph is as follows. As he waited for the cloths to dry, Raghu sat under a tree. He carefully wrote out the alphabets and words he was trying to teach himself. Already he knew two languages, but English was something everybody was learning. He wanted it to learn it too. I guess by reading these two lines, you have got an idea that from which chapter, from which block this paragraph belongs to. After reading this paragraph, you have to answer the five questions that are provided as below. The first question is, what was Raghu waiting for? After reading the paragraph, we came to know that Raghu was waiting for the cloths to dry. Second question, in the meantime, what did Raghu used to do? So in the meantime, Raghu used to teach himself by writing down words and alphabets. Which new language Raghu was learning? So English was the new language that Raghu was learning. Next question, find the word in the passage similar to desire. You have to carefully read the whole passage, then you have to find a similar word that relates to the desired. The word that relates to the desired and given in the paragraph is wanted. So the answer will be wanted. The last question, what is the opposite of the word carefully? You have to simply write the word that means opposite to the word carefully. You can write carelessly or any of the other antonym that you know that is the opposite of the carefully. Now let's come to the writing section. In this question number 3, you have to either write an advertisement or you can draft a notice. The choice is given in this question. The first question you have to do that is write an advertisement for a product glove. We have already discussed this advertisement in a class also. You can draw any of the advertisement. Otherwise, you can also draft a notice for your notice board of your school that your school is organizing a book fair. Just make sure that the proper format is being followed. One sample is given here. First, you have to write the name of your school, then notice, then date, and the subject of the notice. Then you have to write, this is to inform all the students that our school is going to organizing a book fair. In the fair, students can find all sorts of books such as adventurous, comics, study related, and horror. All the students and the parents are invited to attend the book fair. The date, time, and venue of the book fair are as follows. Then you have to mention the date, timing of the book fair, and the venue. That will be a school playground or any other else area. For any further details, please contact the undersigned, Hedge Boy, Hedge Girl, Samir or Samira, the name that is being given in the question. Question number 4, write a letter to your friend inviting him or her for your birthday party. In this question, you have to simply write a letter for your friend to invite him or her for your birthday party. One sample is given here. You can write the letter as per your wish. I am just reading the sample letter. First, you have to write the address and the date and the name of your friend. Okay, then you can write, I know we are both busy with assignments and tests. I have missed you for a long time now. I am celebrating my 13th birthday at Pearl Oceans with a few friends and relatives. The celebration will be on 18th of this month, and my parents want me to invite all my close friends too. You are my best friend even though we stay in different cities now. My parents are trying their best to make it a memorable experience for me. There will be lots of chocolates, foods and games for us. Please be present with uncle and auntie. Do inform them that I will be very disappointed if they miss the party. Hope you won't make me sad. Please send a letter with your confirmation. Love, love and best wishes. Your lovingly, Deepika. You can write any other letter as per your wish, but it should be grammatically correct and make sure that the proper format is being followed. Question number 5. Look at the pictures and write 4 sentences about what is happening in it. You have to just carefully observe the pictures and write any of the 4 sentences relating to this picture. For example, I have written 4 sentences. You can take the example from this or write any of the sentences as your wish. The scene describes the living room of the boy. Second, the boy is engaged in listening to the music. Third, a white cat is sitting on the chair looking at the boy. Fourth, a beautiful green parrot is also there sitting upon the cupboard. Now the next section is the grammar section. Question number 6. Identify the types of noun in the following sentences and underline them. You have to read the following sentences, identify the noun, underline them, and write the type of the noun. It can be there that in one sentence there are more than one noun. You can either underline both of the noun or you can underline any of the one noun as per your wish. For example, the chair is made up of wood. Here are 2 nouns, chair and wood. You can underline any of the nouns or you can underline both of the nouns. I have underlined wood noun, that is material noun. Next sentence, the herd of the cattle is grazing in the field. Herd is a collective noun. All the boys are in the school uniform. Here boys is a common noun. Books are our best friend. Here books is common noun. I purchased a bulb from the market. Here bulb is also a common noun. Sweets are made up of milk. Here milk is a material noun. Question number 7. Identify the tense of the words in bold as simple past or past continuous in the sentences. You have to look at the following sentences. You have to focus on the word that are being bold in the sentences and you have to classify its type, whether it is simple past or past continuous. For example, first sentence. Jekyll jumped upon the prey. Here jumped is simple past, not a past continuous, because we know in the past continuous the verb is with the word ing. Here it's jumped, that is with ed. That's why it's a simple past. Savita was sobbing in the corner. Was sobbing is a word that is related to the past continuous. I was climbing the mountain in my dream. Was climbing is a past continuous. My mother punished me for my nuisances. Punished is a simple past. They lost the match. Here lost is a simple past. They were listening to the priest attentively. Here were listening is past continuous. Question number 8. Circle the subject and underline the predicate in the following sentences. You have to observe the sentences and circle the subject and underline the predicate. For example, in first sentence, Virat adopted our village last week. In this sentence, Virat is a subject and rest of the sentence is a predicate. So you have to circle Virat and underline the rest of the sentence. Again, in the next sentence, the peon is ringing the bell. The peon is a subject and rest of the sentence is a predicate. She is answering to her friend's call. She is the subject here and rest of the sentence is predicate. The last sentence, last night the dogs were barking loudly. Here the dogs are the subject and the rest of the sentence is the predicate. Question number 9. Identify the type of pronouns in the bold in the following sentences. You have to observe the sentences and identify the type of the pronoun of the bold word given in the sentence. The first word is mine. That is in the bold in the sentence, the bag is mine. And we know that mine is a possessive pronoun. The next is these. These comes under the category of demonstrative pronouns. Next, who? The boy who saved my life was Rohan. Here, who represents the relative pronoun. The last one, they all were blaming one another. Here, one another is a reciprocal pronoun. Now, coming to the literature section. This section is completely based on the notes that is being provided to you and your volume book. All the answers of the question number 10, 11 and 12 are there in the notes and the volume book. You can consult the answers from there only. So that's all. Wishing you a lots of luck for your upcoming examinations. All the best, everyone. Stay at home. Stay safe.